Three, two,
Two.
one. Suzanne.
Yeah, it's done. Oh, that feels like it's not done.
That's so funny. Both of us just didn't breathe for that period. Oh my
no,
god. Good morning. Welcome to a moving vlog. This is crazy. I didn't think I'd be super emotional about it, but then I started doing one box and I was like, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. So many memories in this house. Like, it's been our first home, and yeah, it just is very, very weird to do this. All I packed was the games box and I was like, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to pack away like all the things that make it personal, like all the photos of us and everything, and that's gonna be really weird. So what I did do is take like a whole video. I've only done the downstairs so far, but I took a whole video of downstairs just so that I can always like remember it and I can show my children it and like we can always look back on it. Like I said, I love you to mesh on that couch. Like I'm like, oh, this is so special. And so yeah, I'm getting more sentimental. And so I thought I would quickly hop on and say hi. And you can pack like the first proper box with me. Cause the other box was the games box, which is obviously a box. But what I'm thinking I'll pack now is like some of the sentimental stuff so that I can just shift that into my parents' house. And like, that means like wedding albums, photo frames and stuff, which they'll probably just put up. So at least they'll still be going to use, which will be really nice. I must also say Papa Ferns, so Mesh's dad, has just been incredible. He's literally over right now, like cleaning the whole front deck. He did the whole back deck. He just did the whole front area for us. He's then gonna like help us fix the little bits that Benji gnawed when he was a puppy. And so yeah, thank you so much, Dad. We're really, really, really grateful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm just cleaning out this box. I'm just wiping it down because we're gonna be putting like our wedding album and stuff in it at the moment. So this box I want to be really clean. I honestly reckon this box will just transport over and then Mum and Dad will actually just like decorate with all this stuff that I'm putting inside. So it's just such a cute house. It's so funny. Even Mesh just said, it's only when you like start to move that you realize that there's like so much that you put into it, like so many personal touches. Like all of our little photo frames. Like, how cute is that? Just like all the little bits and bobs. Anyway, it's all very exciting. Yes. I'm also just 2.5 weeks after my surgery, so I'm not lifting anything too heavy at the moment and I'm just trying to take it really easy and look after myself a lot. So that makes it slightly harder too because I feel so hopeless, like not being able to fully help and like do everything. But I think I'm doing pretty well. I'm like helping as much as I can. Wouldn't you say, Mesh?
Yeah.
Thank you. Wedding album has gone in. Our wedding guest book. This is what Shani got us when we got engaged. It's our little storybook, which is really nice.
Hello.
It is Monday the 29th, and we've just done like a full day of doing lots of like moving-y bits, and I am so zonked. Oh my goodness. It will be 3 weeks since my surgery tomorrow, and yeah, it's just interesting. Like, I'm definitely not still there yet. I still have my bandages on, so I do need to take them off. I'm just really nervous to see what it looks like. But anyway, the move is on like Donkey Kong and I'm very sleepy. Honestly, I wanted to go to bed at 7 p.m. We forced ourselves to stay awake. We got some Japanese food and we were like, let's just sit and watch something. And everything we picked sucked. And so we were like, oh my gosh, but we finally found something good. So now we're just gonna like lie in bed and watch it. But it's all going really well, I've gotta say. We're like sticking to the plan, like each room day by day, which is nice. And so we're actually a little bit ahead, so that's nice. And tomorrow I think we're gonna do the main living room, but I am just like depersonalizing everything as I go, which is crazy, crazy, crazy. But anyway, I thought I'd just give you a quick reality check of what it's like because I'm very bouncy and excitable most of the time, but right now I am zonked. I also ate like a little, like honestly, like a quarter of a tub of ice cream, and I realized it's probably because I'm like craving energy and I need more energy. That's also because I have really low iron and I haven't taken my supplements in a few days, and I'm trying to like build up my iron reserves. And so I'm gonna go take some iron tablets too. For all you girlies, it's predominantly girlies, that are impacted by this, go and take your iron tablets if you need to. This is your reminder. But anyway, that's all for Monday night. I will talk to you later. Yeah, Benny. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, ooh. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh, Benny. Oh yeah, Papa's got the move. Papa's got it. Papa's got it. Yes, Papa and Benji got it. The realities of moving house. I literally have made myself dinner and I can't be bothered using a plate or a bowl because I'll have to wash it and they will need to be packed. So, eating out of the pan. Darling, you're okay.
Are you scared by the moving or the Taylor Swift singing?
You're okay, bubby boy.
What's wrong, bud? He's a good boy. He's a good boy.
You're a good boy. Yes, darling, you're okay. Press the ray. Hello.
Hello.
And hello. And hello. It is our first open for inspection and we hustled hard. We got the house looking stunning. I'm so proud of us. It looks so, so lovely. I've got to say, like, the last couple of days have been intense, haven't they? Like,
oh, there's people pointing.
Intense. Oh, we're literally like sitting outside.
There's still 4 minutes left.
We're sitting outside inconspicuously in my hat. Just like, we weren't actually planning to be here whilst the open was happening, but we needed to do a handover of keys. And then we just basically sat here anyway. But I'm very proud of us. I've got to say, I'm very proud of us. It's in times like this where it's like really hectic, really busy, that I'm like, babes, we married the right people.
Sorry, I'm keeping an eye. Someone's walking in.
Oh, someone's walking
in. So fourth.
Fourth person. And it's a Thursday today, so
I will just point out, all ethnically the same.
Interesting.
That's all I'm saying.
Interesting.
That's all I'm saying.
Interesting. Anyway, we have obviously got like a car full.
It's like a family in a suit and shit.
We like
suits. How many people can fit in this house?
Okay, so we've got like...
Could call Alex.
Stop talking!
Triple the rent. Triple the rent.
Ooh, that's fun. Okay. I feel like I'm like... Like, you know that woman in The Catcher? Is that what that movie was called? Where she like... Or like that. Anyway, whatever. Basically, we did the whole of downstairs, so it's pretty much all done. We'll just do like a quick zip around now, the day before we like fully move out. And then we've got lots of stuff in the car. We also went to the Nike store today because we have like a discount going. And so it's just been like a crazy day, but honestly, I'm so proud of us. And then tonight, Emily's coming over. I'm gonna make a start on my wardrobe, I think. Or maybe not even my wardrobe, but just like the other bedroom. And just start going through. But anyway, I'm now getting a bit nosy, so I'm gonna have a look at who's walking through our house inconspicuously.
Enough for Mish as well?
No, he can just have some of mine. Em's come over to help me pack, and we are having this very exciting candy cane Christmas hot chocolate. We're very
smell
excited.
Of Christmas.
Yes.
It's kind of like a...
Hello, hello. It is Friday night, and I am in bed with a packet of Doritos. As I'd mentioned, or I'm not actually sure if I would have, but if you've been following my channel, you'd know that I got surgery. So it's been about 3 and a bit weeks now since my surgery. It was like major abdominal surgery. So it was a myomectomy. Anyway, it was a fibroid removal surgery, but basically it really took it out of me. And obviously I then spent like a couple of weeks just in pure recovery. And then literally the third week is when we were like, oh, okay, we're gonna go to New York. And since then I've just been packing and I have definitely overexerted myself. the last few days just getting the house ready for inspections and getting everything packed has been so tiring. And for some reason today, like, we had the first inspection yesterday, did heaps of stuff, have done all of downstairs, and I've started on upstairs now, and we have another inspection tomorrow morning. But for some reason today I have just like absolutely crashed. I am so exhausted and I'm really sad because I was meant to go to one of my amazing friend's birthday dinners, but I woke up and I was just feeling so rubbish and I was in pain and I was exhausted and I had to say I couldn't go. And I feel so bad because I, like, that's just not me. I don't do stuff like that. And I felt really bad, but it was that thing where I was like, I need to make a trade-off here. And if I go to this dinner, I will wreck myself for tomorrow. And tomorrow I need to literally pack up the whole of the upstairs. We have an inspection, so I need to get everything cleaned. Obviously, Mesh will be helping as well, but like, we both need to do all of that. And I reckon if I push too hard right now, if I don't have like a proper, just complete rest, I am cooking myself now. And luckily, Sunday, we have like a family lunch and I've got dinner with some other friends. And so it's like Sunday is a bit more of a chill day. So if this had been tomorrow night, it would have been a bit better, but it's just like tomorrow I need to be so functional. So yeah, anyway, it was sad, but I guess that's like trade-offs that you have to make. And it also just made me think I'm getting older because I reckon if I was younger, I would have just pushed myself to go, but then completely wrecked myself for tomorrow, which is a very important day to get everything done. Whereas I've been like, no, I need to heal, I need to recover, because I need to be functional tomorrow and I need to be functional for the rest of the week because there's just so much to do. But yeah, I just thought it was really funny that I'm literally sitting here eating a bag of Doritos and my leftover Thai food. And I'm so tired. But honestly, so proud. We have achieved so much in the last few days. The last 3 days have just been like the biggest push ever. And then today again, I was doing all of my wardrobe stuff. Sham came over, which was really nice. I should have filmed it, but no, that was really, really nice. But yeah, I'm just so wrecked. And I'm proud of myself for making the very hard decision to stay home and miss out on seeing my friends. But yeah, I gotta look after my body right now because there is too much going on in life. But yeah, anyway, that is that. I thought I'd just check in. The realities of moving. It is chaos. I should say chaos. It's not chaos. It's actually very organized. It's just so much stuff. Like, there is just so much to do. And I think the fact that I've had surgery makes it so much harder because I don't have the same energy levels. I get pain, all that shebang. But we're getting there. We are getting there. I'm not going to say slowly because it's actually been very rapidly. Rapidly and surely, we are getting there. I actually need to book in removalists. So I'm going to call tomorrow and book in someone to come and remove stuff on Wednesday. And I think we're going to be right on track. I think we're doing well. But my gosh, like, stuff like, sorry, I just remember, like, the TV needs to come off. Like, what, who, when, how does that happen? I don't know. I was saying as well, this is my first move where I'm an adult and I'm in charge. It's crazy. The other times I've moved, I've been a child and so mum and dad have handled it, or alternatively I moved into this house to live with Mesh, but that was kind of like a gradual progression because throughout COVID I slowly started bringing stuff over and started having a bit of a wardrobe here. And then when I like moved in, I still have so much stuff at my family home. So it didn't feel like a dramatic, like, I'm packing boxes and bringing them here. Because my childhood bedroom literally looks the exact same. And I would just like bring like clothes over to this house, but in batches. So this is very much my first move. And I have a whole new appreciation for the amount of effort that goes into it. But it is fun. It is fun. I reckon if it just wasn't for my post-surgery state where I'm not like 100% and I can't lift heavy, I can't like reach for things, it would be easier. But we're getting there and I'm very proud of myself. So yeah, that's all for now. I'll keep you lifted. Bye.
Hi, can we show everyone your bling? Whoa, what a cool dude, my little rap star, rock star.
This is cute, isn't it? I just took my hair out of a ponytail. Oh, you know when you take your hair out and it's like slightly painful as well. Anyway, oh my, oh my. If this isn't a if this isn't a representation of how I'm feeling right now, oh my goodness gracious me, I am so blooming tired. I don't want this entire vlog to be just me talking about how tired I am, but I just want to give myself some credit because I had surgery nearly a month ago now, but pretty much since like week 2.5 to 3, like this last week really has just been so intensely packing, and I'm still meant to be recovering and resting, and it's just been so go, go, go. And I just need to give myself some credit because it has been crazy. It has been absolutely wild. Oh my gosh, moving house is no easy feat. And it's just no easy feat regardless of if you've just had surgery. And if you've just had surgery on your like core, really not easy. Really, really not easy. But anyway, we're getting there, it's fine. I did have like a moment yesterday night. We were doing the Chilean visa, and it's like a pretty intense process. You have to like give lots of documentation, you have to like show your bank accounts and just stuff that we were a bit like, this is really intensive. Like, we've never had to do a visa like that before, and it just felt a little bit strange. And so I then was like, hey, I wonder if this is a sign, like, are there any other flights available? Because we're booking on points. And so then we had a look, and there was a flight available the day before our flight. And I was like, oh my gosh. And it was like a direct flight. And I was like, oh my God, that's so intense. Because then we'd also need to have accommodation for the 5 days beforehand. I need to get everything packed and done like a day early. I'm also such an emotional, sentimental person. And I want to have time to say goodbye to like my friends, but also just like my family. We're not going to see our family in so long. And that would take away a night that we were going to spend with the family. And then also, because we're staying in New York for 3 months, we then would have exceeded the 3 month threshold. So we'd have to now move our London flight earlier as well. So it's just like lots of change. And I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. But then instead of that, we found other flights that were on the 25th of May, which is 10 days later than originally planned. And so we haven't made any decisions yet. And last night I was just like really having a moment where I was like, this is all too hard. Like, everything is so hard. I also had to like cancel on some friends that I was meant to have dinner with tonight just because I'm so exhausted. Like, I don't think I've ever been this tired. Just with recovery and then like packing up the house and then like all the paperwork and just all the thinking and like stuff that's required with like leaving your house and changing your address and all that jazz. Like, and then leaving to go to, you know, a year or so of traveling around the world. Like, there's a lot to do. So I basically just had a moment and listened to Waiting on a Miracle in Encanto, because I was like, I'm fine, I'm not fine. And there's that line in it where she's like, I'm fine, I'm totally fine, I'm not fine, I'm not fine, I can't move the mountain. And I was like, that is how I feel right now. Like, I'm not fine. I am like hanging on by a thread right now. I can't move the bloody mountain because I can't carry any weights right now because I'm in recovery. My uterus hurts every like 20 minutes. It's just like a whole thing. And I was like, I'm not fine. Maybe this is a sign that we need to just like shift by 10 days. Initially I was like, oh, but then that feels so weird because that then means that we're leaving in 3 weeks instead of in a week. No, sorry. We're leaving in 3 weeks instead of leaving in a week and a half. But then I realized that's only a week and a half extra. If we still go to the timeline of like moving out of this house and like having everything packed, what it does mean is that we'll just have a week and a half to spend time with our friends and family and just also rest so that by the time we get to New York, we're actually like, oh, cool, let's do this. Because at the moment, I reckon I would get to New York and just be like, I need like a week of no one talk to me. I'm just going to sit here and eat takeout. Like, I'm so tired and I really need to rest. So anyway, that is what's happening. That's potentially what we're leaning towards. I will keep you updated. I don't know, but I guess that's kind of the theme of it, which is cool, which is exciting. And it's something new that's different for us as well. So getting there, proud of ourselves. Mama Ferns is coming over today and disassembling our bed. I'm now going through our toiletries again, or like my toiletries, and just doing the things that you gotta do. It's moving day, literally taking all the stuff out now. We have officially moved in to my parents' house, which is so nice. And we are having our first little dinner together. We're gonna pick something to watch. We've got some Thai food on the way. My mum's made some amazing food, and we're in like full sleepover form, and we're here for it. Are you here for it?
Here for it.
Hey, how you doing?
This one's off.
It's really hot.
They'll get used to the vlogs. Hi, Binge. Hi. Hi.
This is not going to work out very well for me. I'm taking photos.
Mister. Where are you looking? What are you looking at?
Hi, I'm Benji.
Just not the cover at all.
Most of these players, while they're playing, they're fit.
And they train so much physically, but they need to eat so much. Mm-hmm. So they eat so much, and they're used to eating like 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 calories a day.
Having our favorite New York style choc chip cookie from our favorite place called the Turak in honor of Benji. Because that's where he's staying. Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3, and then put your hands down. Okay. Are you ready, Dad? Okay. Okay, welcome to our first home. So, we walk here. Look how lovely. This is the essential. You've got our cutie pie Benny standing here waiting for you at the door. Number 2. This is our home. Lots of details. This is our shoe rack that Greg and Mesh made. And Greg got this one the wrong way around, which is so funny. And then keep looking. Mesh, I loved him on that couch. Look at our beautiful home. Got this lovely outdoor area with our barbecue. The best storage in the whole world. Look at all that storage all across here. Look at our beautiful home. Details. It's just been the best home. Look at our little fridge. The only magnet we're missing is one from
the Maldives, but we'll have to get one when we go next time. This is our beautiful fridge. Lots of lovely flowers. This is from my old bedroom. Mum and Dad gave us these paintings. This is Mesh's old TV. This is where we keep lots of cute little bits and bobs. That's our wedding album and our wedding book. It's just the most adorable little home. Mesh, Shabi and Benji. Where the dog is. And you're the dog, aren't you? Look at the best Papa Fern doing all the hard work for us. Hi! This is our gate for Benji. When Benji was a puppy, he gnawed the skirting board. How helpful of him. So now we are redoing that, and Papa Ferns, again, the best, has come over to help. Benji also gnawed all of this, but luckily that's just going straight in the bin. But look at our home. Isn't it the best? Is this your bedroom? This is Benji's bedroom. This is where Benji sleeps. This is Benny's bedroom, isn't it? This is your couch. These are two of your girlfriends. Yes, yes, yes it is. Good boy.
Even though I minimally use this part, we'll just show it. This is our laundry. Benji's had his first bath in there. I do all my party supplies. This is Benji's area. Literally on this couch right here is where I told Mesh I love him. He said it to me already, and we were just like cuddling on the couch and like playing around, and it was really fun. I think we had the whole thing open because this pulls out as well. So we had the whole thing open and we were just playing around, and then I told him I loved him. And I do, I love your daddy, and I love you, and I love you. Oh, this has been a feature in the house for a while. This is when Theo came over for drinks and bought a huge slab and literally drank a couple, and there's so many left, and he has decided to keep them here for us. Oh my gosh, I remember. So Benj, when we first got him, he'd never known what steps are. And so we used to go upstairs and we didn't need a gate because he couldn't come upstairs. And then one time I remember we heard like a little clatter, and it was Benji who'd like tried to come up and tried to explore the world and then had a little tumble, and then we obviously looked after him, and that's when we got the gate. pretty green window. Hi, let's go. Photos from our wedding. I just think it's so cool. So we've had this in the background of like all of our work calls. We've been like manifesting it in the background because like this is what you can see when you're on a work call with us. And I'm gonna take it down now because we're gonna be there. We're literally going to be here. We can see this building from our apartment. Like that is crazy. Manifested it.
Come on.
Let's go. Let's go. Come on. I want to see what he does. What in the heck, bitch?
Seems like we've been robbed.
What in the heck? What in the heck? What happened?
I'm about to go to your family boxes.
I need to shower. It's going to take care of you.
You want to see her outside? What? What? Bench, come on, let's go upstairs. Let's go upstairs. Ready? Okay, let's go. What in the heck? There's no TV. There's no bed. What's happened? Pinju, what about the other rooms? Come on, let's check. What's here? Wow, Mummy did such a good job at clearing all the rooms so quickly. Thanks, Betty. Binge, last room. Come on.
It's weird, isn't it?
Here, darling, you're okay. Binge. Binge, come here.
Good boy.
That's okay. We have one picture still up. Yay! This is gonna be a bad angle.
Sorry, this is a super